it's interesting that Black America has been criminalized during and post-slavery consistently, given the fact that America is what's called a criminogenic society. Criminogenic means criminality is in the genetic detail or genetic makeup of a person, place, or thing, right? We're personifying objects. So in America's very DNA is crime. And so one could argue the fact that America became America due to three original sins, two of which being absolute inhumane behavior, the genocide or near genocide of First Nation peoples, and slavery, that the very nature of America is crime, criminal behavior, and inhumanity. And so what is more American than crime because of the criminogenic nature of our society, right? Even wealth, you know, in America was built in many cases on a criminal act, like the bootlegging Kennedys, on some form of exploitation akin to slavery, and even post-slavery, making so much more than frontline workers and not providing basic needs. That's exploitation, right? And then the prison industrial complex, as an example, right, where you have folks who are in prison working for pennies a day while the corporations receiving those products get millions, right? One great example is Idaho potatoes. Those potatoes have been farmed, I don't know if they still are, but have historically been farmed by inmates for pennies on the dollar, and then that corporation makes a killing on the profit, right? So exploitation, criminal activity, and slavery, right? Even your boy 45, the way that the Trump family made their money was on exploitation and criminal behavior, because Trump does not pay his bills, right? So he'd rather sue you than pay you for work that you've already done. That's criminal and exploitative, right? So that's how people in America, white people historically, have made their money. No matter how nice they are, no matter how liberal they may be, there is some form of exploitation, criminality, that's happening to generate the inordinate amounts of wealth that America has. That's one. America is a criminogenic society. The very core of its being is a criminal nature, right? So from that perspective, calling these young men criminals is really like calling them Americans. So that's one. We have to understand the pathology of America. Right.
I am my brother's keeper. And when you say the name Jacob Blake, make sure you say father. Make sure you say cousin. Make sure you say son. Make sure you say uncle. But most importantly, make sure you say human. Human life. Let it marinate in your mouth, in your mind. A human life. Just like every single one of y'all and everywhere around the world, we're human. And his life matters. So many people have reached out to me telling me they're sorry that this happened to my family. Well, don't be sorry, because this has been happening to my family for a long time, longer than I can account for. It happened to Emmett Till. Mm. Emmett Till is my family. Mm. Philando, Mike Brown, mm. Sandra. This has been happening to my family. And I've shed tears for every single one of these people that it's happened to. This is nothing new. I'm not sad. I'm not sorry. I'm angry. Mm. And I'm tired. Mm. I haven't cried one time. I stopped crying years ago. Mm. I am numb. Mm. I have been watching police murder people that look like me for years. Mm. I'm also a Black history minor. So not only have I been watching it in the 30 years that I've been on this planet, but I've been watching it for years before we were even alive. I'm not sad. I don't want your pity. I want change. Mm.